Bernie Sanders wants to know why corporations that break the law are receiving billions of dollars worth of government contracts. And that's a really good question. He came out and he said, look, why would we have Amazon? Why would we give $10 billion to this union-busting freak who tries to make everybody believe that life is good for the workers around Amazon? Why do we give him $10 billion? Because, Mr. President, oh, by the way, all you have to do is do an executive order and you can stop all that. What's preventing Biden from doing that? That's the question that Bernie Sanders is raising.
And I think, honestly, this is a question that is probably decades overdue at this point. Why? Not just Amazon, but any company, which is pretty much all of them that we know of, that breaks the law. They're out there doing horrible things like laundering money for terrorists, poisoning the environment, poisoning humanity. And we just give them all this money because, well, you're the best there is at what you do. So here's another $10 billion, Mr. Bezos. Have fun with your Washington Post. Have fun, you know, with your workers peeing in bottles because you don't even give them bathroom breaks. Oh, and don't be afraid to spend a little bit of this on your union-busting law firms you hire.
Yeah, some great articles come out about what the trade-off was. Washington Post, of course, loves everything, no matter how crazy it is that this administration does. It's all okay. Washington Post is always there for him. So on the other side, you've got Biden who's taken all that in. Thanks a lot. Appreciate it. But all he has to do is sign an executive order and said, we're not going to give this corporate welfare to people who do union busting because we care about workers. And if you'll think about it, that was one of Biden's campaign promises. He came into office, he said, look, I'm gonna stop this union busting. He was talking about the tech companies. The tech companies are doing all these terrible things to unions. He was talking about Amazon. And that was one of the things he ran on. And he even used the idea, I can do an executive order if you put me in office. Instead, he gives these creeps around Amazon $10 billion along with $3 billion worth of subsidies.
Right. And then, of course, you know, the additional $40 billion, whatever, for the microchip research that this billion-dollar company allegedly wants to do. The $10 billion, of course, is just kind of a gift in and of itself. That's not necessarily earmarked for anything. That is just a gift on top of the rest of the tens of billions to
Well, somebody's got to ask, we can't, I refuse to allow you or I to stand up here and, you know, let's clap for Biden again when we can see it. I mean, all he has to do is do an executive order. He could stop all this immediately. But he's getting great, great articles coming out of the Washington Post.
But, you know, it also reminds you of what we almost had here, because I guarantee if he was in that White House, we would have had that executive order day one.
Oh, absolutely.